Good morning. Let us talk about minutes of a meeting today. Minutes, once we have a meeting in an organization, whatever has transcribed, we need to record. So, the official record of proceedings at a meeting are known as minutes. All organizations, whether commercial or social, attach great significance to maintaining a proper record of the business transacted at various meetings. The validity as well as the legality of the proceedings depends on the faithful recording of minutes. Not just recording, but approval of the minutes also hold a lot of significance. They are summaries of actions taken and not verbatim or word by word record of the deliberations or the transcriptions, discussions held in the meeting. They should include only objective data and actions and not subjective generalities, and should report only the facts presented and the actions taken in a meeting. Personal opinions and emotions, feelings, they are not recorded in the minutes of the meeting. Usually, minutes contain the purposeful synthesis of the main ideas concerned and discussed, the actions taken, conclusions reached at, and the recommendations made. Even the tasks that are assigned to various individuals or groups in the meeting are put in the record in the minutes. A creative, meaningful, and purposeful synthesis of ideas and actions is a useful and significant official record, which is also known as minutes of a meeting. The main objectives of minutes are that it is to record concisely and accurately the business transacted in a meeting. They serve as a permanent record for the future reference in an organization. They serve as a reminder of the actions to be taken to implement the decisions arrived at a meeting. Minutes can be produced as evidence in court of law, and in case of joint stock companies, the law requires that the company maintain a proper record of the minutes of meeting. Minutes help the committee achieve its purpose faster with less effort. They form the basis of future action. They also, not just form the basis of future action, but they form the basis of agenda of the further meetings as well. They ensure a common understanding of decisions taken and the proposals that are forwarded in a meeting. Minutes provide continuity for the group's thinking and are a moving force for action. There are two types of minutes: minutes of resolution and minutes of narration. Minutes of resolution only records the resolutions passed at in a meeting. The language of such minutes is, it is resolved that, and then it is followed by the exact resolution that has been taken. In case there is a voting in the meeting, then the movers and the seconders of the resolution, they are not mentioned. Even the voting pattern, the number of votes for and against, they are not recorded in minutes of resolution. Whilst minutes of narration, in this, the resolutions passed at a meeting are recorded along with a brief account of the business discussed. Certain details are given in minutes of narration. The voting pattern is recorded, and it is more on the pattern of a report. The minutes of narration more likely to be on the pattern of report. Confirmation of minutes. They say that it is important to ratify or verify the minutes. So usually at the next meeting, the first agenda is minutes of the previous meeting, and it is read before it is signed by the chairman. If there are any changes that are to be made, if somebody says that no, it is this that was discussed and should be recorded instead of what has been done, then that is the time when it needs to be done. And before the chairman signs the minutes, all the changes are done, and then it is considered that the minutes are confirmed. It is also known as verification of minutes. Delivery of minutes again plays a significant role. They say that prompt delivery of minutes minutes is very, very important. Guiding, because minutes serve as a basis of action. If the minutes are not delivered on time, then they lose their significance. It no longer helps anybody to for any kind of action that is taken. The legal requirement says that every company maintain minutes of the proceedings, and before 30 days they are to be circulated amongst all, and then they should be signed by the chairman. Minutes normally should show the nature of the meeting and description of the committee. When we write minutes, there is a certain format that we adhere to, and in that we see that the first thing that comes is the classification of the nature of the meeting. What exactly is it? It means that supposedly the committee that is meeting, it is say annual general meet, is meeting for annual general meeting, or it is a regular or a monthly meeting, then that should be classified. There should be a heading and number which is followed by explanation. As we discussed in agenda, supposedly it is the 12th general body meeting of a company. So then the agenda item would begin with 12. And it becomes 12.01, where 12 stands for the number of the meeting that is being held, and 1 stands for the first agenda point. Then each item should be written in the same order in which the business was transacted. Here I would like to add that whilst we are preparing the agenda, one needs to be very, very careful, and all non-controversial agenda items should be put in the beginning, followed by the controversial or items that would require a lot of debate and discussion, so that most of the items that we have thought of or planned of to discuss in a meeting are taken beforehand, and then in case something controversial happens, then it can be given a lot of time without hampering or eating away into the time of the other agenda items. Similarly, if we have put the business in certain order in agenda, then that same order in the meeting we should discuss it, and whilst recording and in minutes of meeting, it should be recorded in the same order that was put in the agenda, that was discussed in the meeting, and now it figures in the minutes as well. The language of the minutes should be very, very simple and precise. In anything that is office communication, which the information that flows in office amongst the people, flowery, idiomatic language should be avoided. The language should be as simple as possible, but it should be grammatically accurate. Accuracy of writing mechanics holds a very significant place in office communication and in minutes also. Precision again lends a lot of coherence, a lot of unity to what we have written. If we are not to the point, and then it becomes a little difficult for the reader to recollect what exactly happened, and people tend to go wayward, haywire. So it is important that we be precise and we be concise as well whilst writing minutes. Now, law says that entries should be made in the minute book kept for the purpose within 30 days of the conclusion of every meeting. 30 days is a long enough duration for the people preparing the minutes of the meeting and circulating it to everybody. Everybody needs to read the minute and confirm. Once the chairman signs, then it is considered to be official, and all this should be done within 30 days of the meeting, 30 days of the date of the meeting. The pages of the minute book need to be consecutively numbered, and every page must be signed by the chairperson. A minute book without the signatures of the chairperson has no legal validity. No legal sanctity is given to such a minute book. Let's look at the structure of the minutes. They say that generally every organization follows the same structure for minutes. The in the center we have the name of the organization, followed by the address of the organization. And then we have the date and place of the meeting, or the venue of the meeting. Then we have the classification and number of the meeting if it is in series. As I told you earlier, if it is the 12th general body meeting, then we need to give that 12th becomes very, very significant because it would figure in the subsequent minutes as well. And then the names of the members who are present. here, not just the names of the members who are present is mentioned, but also the names of the members who are not attending the meeting for whatever reasons. There is a line that is written that leave of absence was granted to so and so for personal reasons or official reasons, whatever the reasons be. But it is put in record that certain people were not present in the meeting. Next comes in attendance, names of those in attendance. At times it so happens that we invite people. They are not part of that core meeting committee, but their presence is significant. So we invite people from outside to be a part of the meeting, listen to the deliberations and offer valuable guidelines to the proceedings. Where do we put those names? That is, those names all figure in attendance. They are special invitees and their names. At times, certain organizations do not mention the word in attendance. They write special invitees. And usually, in attendance is also a prevalent or a common term. The first agenda item, the first minute item begins is, it refers to previous meetings, minutes of previous meetings and their confirmation. If we look at agenda, then even the first agenda item always is confirmation of minutes of previous meeting. So similarly, I told you earlier that in the minutes, it is everything is recorded as per the order listed in the agenda, which is carried out in the minutes in the meeting while we are transacting or deliberating on it, and then they figure in the same order in the minutes as well. So first is reference to minutes of previous meeting and the confirmation. Then starts the various transactions that are to be done. For instance, if we are deliberating on appointing a new person, then what exactly would be the designation, what would be the profile, the pay structure, whatever that is discussed becomes the second point. The third point, if for example is that, okay, once we have this thing done, then we are assigning budget to certain activities. So that becomes the third agenda item. And then we have, if that is required, then we have appendix as well in minutes where we put secondary material, which may not be significant to be put in the major things, but we put it as appendix, which may help somebody reading the minutes to get a proper perspective of the context that was being discussed and the reason why certain decisions were taken. And then we have signature of the secretary and the chairperson who is writing the minutes. Normally there is a secretary and there is a chairperson. Secretary always writes the minutes in consultation with the chairperson. So all those things are recorded and both of the people will sign. It should be taken, the care should be taken that all points are recorded and no details are omitted. They should be brief. Emotions, defamatory language, irrelevant points should not be recorded. The tone of the minutes should be very, very impersonal and it should be written in third person. Dates and figures should be clearly and precisely stated in the minutes. If a reference is made to a certain letter or report, then the number and date should be clearly mentioned, and it is necessary so that any kind of ambiguity or misunderstanding does not take place. If possible, we could include those things even in the appendix as suggested earlier. Simple past tense and passive voice is what is recommended in minutes. Separate paragraphs should be used for each item and entries should be kept for 30 days as I told you earlier. They also say that minutes of the meeting should contain a very fair summary of whatever has been discussed in a meeting. Emphasis should be given to items such as responsibilities delegated. To who all did we assign a particular task should be very clearly mentioned. Then how does it help? When a member receives his copy, then he is reminded of the work he has to perform. The emphasis and distribution helps in proper functioning of the group. Minutes thus serve as an aid also. And then let us look at the example, one example of minutes. I have given it to you here in the center, as I told you, figures the name of the organization followed by the address, minutes, and then we write down the details as to when, where, and what happened. So it is third meeting of the executive committee, third here becomes very, very significant. Third specifies that this meeting is usually held in series and is a regular feature. And then we have the detail of the meeting, executive committee. We have the date, place, and the venue where it is being held. Number of people present, their names and their designation, members absent, and in attendance if there is anybody. In attendance or special invitee, both are similar. There are two ways of writing a minute. Yes, I did tell minutes of resolution and minutes of narration, but when we actually put it down on paper, then also there are two ways of presenting that same information. One is in tabular form and the other is in paragraph form. Let us first see the tabular form. In tabular form, we have three columns. The first is number of minutes, the subject of minutes, and the details of minutes. Now, because it is the third executive committee meeting, so the first minute item becomes 3.01. Subject of the minutes is confirmation of minutes of previous meeting. And then we write that, okay, such and such meeting was held on such and such date, and the minutes were circulated to everybody. And because no comments have been received or everybody has confirmed to it, they are approved by the committee members and they are signed by the chairperson. The next becomes, for example, here I have given 3.02 as director's annual report. Now here the description comes in. The details is the description. What was done? So the director's report was circulated and it was taken as read, and it was reported that the director reported the progress and highlighted the achievements. Next is 3.03, annual accounts. We give the details of that as well. And then if there is no other item, then we come to 3.04, any other item with the permission of the chair. Now, this is a regular feature. There are times when we circulate the agenda, people start deliberating upon the agenda, and there are times that certain things come up which are not included in the original agenda. But they need to be discussed, they are important. And so, those items are discussed here. They do not find a place in the agenda for the meeting, but they can be discussed here in any other item with the permission of the chair. And if there is no such agenda item, then we write no agenda. And last is 3.05, wherein next meeting. Here, it is customary to decide on the next date of meeting. That not just helps people in keeping their deadlines, but it also gives a fair perspective to all the group members that yes, we need to finish our work within this stipulated period and the reporting will happen on this day. So it helps everybody to keep track of time and track of what they are doing. Here we see that both the chairperson and the secretary has signed, and then there is a date. This date differs from the date the meeting was held at. The meeting was held at a certain date, and after that the minutes are written. This pattern is again the paragraph pattern. The heading remains the same. The name of the organization, minutes, details, present, absent, and attendance remain the same. It is only how we present the details. Earlier we saw that we presented it in a tabular form. Now this is in the agenda form. But everything else remains the same. This is the number of minutes. It is here, it is 6.01, because in the details I gave that it is the sixth meeting of sixth meeting of the annual general committee or executive committee. So the minutes of the previous meeting are confirmed here. 6.02, we have certain other agenda items. We have 03, we have 4, any other item with the permission of the chair. And here, it can be so that we decide on the next meeting date in the same heading, any other item with the permission of the chair. In the table version, we saw that we have given 6.05 next meeting and then we give the details. It can be written in both the manners. It can be written as a separate point and it can be merged with the any other item with the permission of the chair. It is again signed and the date is given. Minutes, they are an invaluable tool because they serve to, they are not just an aid for memory, but they also are a repository of future information, of information for future reference. They also help people in coordinating the work of the company. creative, fair representation of minutes, of meetings is very, very important, because based on that, a lot of decisions will be taken. If the minutes are recorded inaccurately, the decisions would be inaccurate and it would be a disaster in the long run. Thank you.